Once when he was thin, he had flown to old Hong Kong and had learned the secret of life and the sea and the sky beyond. So he gave up his diet and sat in a tree and ate himself through eternity.
For Freya said Bigwig, I heard the commotion beginning before I heard another sound. It sounded like a roodly doodly doo. That does seem to get at the first, and some of them began kittens, and they were attacking any rabbits who came near them. They wanted to fight and protect the kittens, you know. Very soon the runs were crammed with rabbits clawing and clambering over each other. They weren't the runs that they were accustomed to using, and they found them that blocked. Some managed to turn around.
R is the ideal gas constant, and T is the temperature in degrees Kelvin. Now, when we take this and put it together using Boyle's Law and Charles' Law and Benny, I am sick and tired of your disrespectful moaning and groaning.
Yawning is a perfectly natural human response.
You get out of here. Go to the office. Get out of here. I'm sick and tired.
So you have a banana for 45 cents and a candy bar that costs $1.05. Which should you buy?
The candy bar, because I hate bananas.
That's just incorrect.
So, what'd you guys do over the summer?
I touched a dead mouse and got the hantavirus.
I went to scout camp, where I made 3 new friends. One enemy. Mobius!
So, what about you, Chedda? I rode my bicycle around. So you guys ready for a new school year?
I guess. I don't even see why I even have to come to school. I'm already pretty good at arithmetic.
But do you test well in arithmetic?
No.
That's why you're here. Don't worry, guys. We have each other. You're my best friends in the whole wide world. If you were cats, I'd let you shed on my couch.
You ever noticed how I'm Benny, you're Chedley, and he's Lenny? All of our names end with a Y. Why is that?
I have a theory. People whose names don't end with a Y are freaks who were born with both reproductive organs.
Sounds perfectly reasonable.
So, you guys ready to hang out in my basement?
Your basement sucks, dude.
It's better than your tiny basement.
Shut up! I'm very self-conscious about my basement size.
I'm bored.
Weak.
could get high.
You don't need drugs to get high.
Prove it.
I will. Check this out.
3, 2, 1. Yeah!
Whoa. You're right, Chedley. This television is intense. Good thing you put the mattress down. We could have been killed. Well, let's bounce.
Where are you going? The party's just getting started. Don't go.
Your basement's lame, and it smells like cat piss.
Good. That means they've claimed me as their own.
Well, your basement's also boring.
What? There are endless possibilities in this basement. We could play Twister. We could tear up the carpet and write a profanity on the cement and then cover it up again. Doesn't that excite you?
Well, maybe a little bit. But we're gonna go to the county fair. See you later.
Fine. I hope your roller coaster capsizes.
This is Channel 6, your only logical choice for nightly news. Tonight's top story. Raja, the infamous tiger, escaped from police custody today. The tiger is of great interest to the scientific community because it was born without claws or teeth. We advise everyone to stay indoors until the tiger skips town on a local bus, killing everyone on board. Zookeepers say the tiger also has a taste for the stringy meat of tall, gangly teenage boys. And meteorologist Ted Farnsworth predicts that if you are tall and skinny, there is an 88% chance you will be mauled.
88% chance of being mauled. What are the odds?
Weather in the region continues to be frozen in time, and to begin our next story, we give you the national anthem.
Can't touch this.
I sense danger. It's probably just my prepubescent hormones. You just lucked out, Tiger. Because if I had a sharp bamboo stick on me, you'd be penetrated. I'm relatively unscathed. I'll go on a bike ride to ease the pain.
County fair for the win, dude.
Yeah, man. What ride are you going on first?
I'm going on the Ring of Fire.
Forget that. I'm going on the snake ride.
Snake ride's cool, I guess. After that, let's go on the ride where you try to shoot pigs in the head with the crossbow.
Don't you feel bad? They squeal when you shoot them.
Dude, they only squeal because of a chemical imbalance caused by an arrow in the brain.
Oh.
Wow, that pig ride was disappointing. I think they sedated him so they wouldn't squeal as much.
Yeah.
What kind of dark carnival is this?
Hey, boys. You want to buy some M-rated video games?
Didn't President Thompson make those illegal in 2010?
Don't they make you kill children?
Nah, I've been to juvie before. What could happen now?
Well, now that you're here, I guess I'll have to mug you.
Wow. This twist is blowing my mind!
Oh, I'll blow your mind. But by blow your mind, I mean shoot you in the head.
Why are you doing this?
Class struggle.
I have class struggle. The teacher says I'm dyslexic.
Give me all you got.
What? The Ring of Fire was 20 bucks.
Must happen to enter rage. Rage is building. Ah! God sucks. This. Ah! I'm gonna go. Ah!
Yeah!
I told that guy what's up. Oh, Lenny. Why'd you have to be a hero?
So, why didn't you stop the mugger, Benny?
I got shot in the head.
Yowzer.
Sorry, boys. He's untraceable.
Can't you get a DNA sample or something?
Do you really think that'll hold up in court?
Just wish someone would help us.
Stop in my head and mount your
That's the last straw. He didn't have to do that.
Why do the innocent have to suffer? Why couldn't the tiger who mauled me have mauled the man who threw the bottle? Why couldn't the tiger who mauled me maul the man who threw the bottle? Cat on man. That makes half man. Half cat. It's time to make a difference. We'll need top-of-the-line equipment. Good thing my mom taught me how to sew during the Second Great Depression. Amazing. We'll be half cat, half Charles Barkley. There's something missing. What would we be called? Chedda Cats. Chedda Cats. Chedda. Oh. The Chedda Cats. Operator, put me through to Benny. Benny, meet me at the city park. I have urgent news. Bring Lenny. Bring Lenny because if this doesn't work out, we'll be pretty insecure, and we'll need someone to poke fun at. Chedda Cats, move. Yeah! Have a seat, boys. Boys, we've been friends for a period of time now, and I think it's time we took it to the next level.
Oh, really?
Imagine three half-man, half-cat mercenaries roaming the streets, preying on bank robbers and identity thieves. All I'm asking you guys is, do you want to fight crime with me?
Fight crime? Do I look like Jay Leno?
Lenny, you're the least funny person I've ever laid eyes on.
Stop this bickering. Look, the state's in ruins. The streets are running rampant with crime. People are dying. That 86-year-old woman across the street from me, she died.
Dude, that old lady, she died of natural causes.
Last time I checked, death wasn't natural, Benny.
You should know how bad things are. Your dad's in prison.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
What'd he do?
He illegally downloaded a car.
So, are you guys in?
I'm not sure, dude. I got some pretty important stuff to do this week.
What stuff?
Yard work?
Yard work can wait.
Yard work cannot wait. Grass is a status symbol. And if you forget to water it, it forgets to produce oxygen. Last week, I forgot to water the lawn, and it forgot to produce oxygen, and I passed out in the basement. It may have been the uncontrollable coal fire in the basement, but probably not. It was probably the grass that's exacting its revenge upon my soul.
I, too, get pretty busy. I have to clean my gazebo daily.
You can clean your gazebo any day. You get one chance to fight crime.
On the contrary, my foster mom says you get your whole life to fulfill your childhood. You only get one gazebo. I mean, I'm gonna miss it. Sometimes I get to clean out leaves, sometimes there's a tumbleweed, and sometimes there's more leaves than you can possibly imagine.
Come on, let's fight some crime.
We can tell bank robbers not to rob banks. We can find abusers of power, and we can make punts and hurt them.
We can find people that butt in line and crack their skulls open.
We won't just crack their skulls. We'll shove their head into a wall while we crack their skulls.
And then we can find identity thieves and tell them to get a life. Get it?
It's pretty funny, Lenny. In bizarre world.
Well, we can help orphans, right?
I was never a big fan of orphans. I mean, they're smelly. They take no initiative to get a job and support themselves. All they want is money to buy their booze. So, are you guys in for making a difference?
I guess we did get mugged.
I didn't get mugged, Lenny. You got mugged. Your body releases pheromones that says, "Hi, I'm Lenny. I like being taken advantage of. Why don't you pistol whip me daily?" So forget it, Chedley. If we take criminals off the streets, they will feel cheated and unappreciated. And besides, you probably don't even have a good name for us. What do you have picked out? Come on.
Chedda Cats.
Chedda Cats? Why not Chedda Dogs, which is a cool animal?
Well, we'll use Chedda Dogs if we go underground and start peddling dope. We'll be like, "Hey, do you want some cheddar? Surprise, it's actually an illegal substance." And then that bystander will be like, "Oh, what a pleasant surprise. I've always wanted to be addicted to something that degenerated me in every way."
Do you have costumes picked out for us?
Oh, I got the suits. And when you put them on, it makes you feel super fly.
Super fly?
Super fly. See for yourself.
Put the suit on.
Ready to fight some crime?
Yes, but before we go, can I make a humorous cat noise?
You go right on ahead.
Meow.
So, how do you fight crime?
You know, I'm not really sure. I always assumed you find someone who looks suspicious, and you hurt them. All right, boys. You stake out over here. I'll stay scouting over by a nearby tree. We'll stay in contact with this walkie-talkie. You know I've spotted a crook if I sputter a witty and whimsical code. For example, the Cheerios are in the milk.
I read you.
All right, Delta 2, this is Delta 1. I'm in position. So, you guys ready to make a career out of this? Even if we don't make any money out of it?
But how do we eat, Chedley? How do we eat?
I reckon one of the crooks we bust will have a Subway card or something. Or we can convince an old lady we saved that she has a life debt to feed us.
Old ladies cook great, especially when they're senile.
Yeah. You gotta love that senile banana bread. This is Delta 1. Santa's bobbing for apples and Mama's baking a sweet surprise.
Is that a witty phrase?
You're damn right. It's the Unabomber. Let's move in.
10-4, good buddy. 10-4!
What are we gonna do? There's like four limbs on that guy.
He's an adult, man. I heard they can lift 2 tons of reinforced steel rebar. And they can buy illegal drugs.
Don't worry. We'll circle around, form a protective triangle, and clasp our hands. He can't escape. Move in. Excuse me, sir? Sir, we're going to bust you.
Oh,
Please, sir. I need this money to feed my family.
You monster! His sister has leukemia and he's dying!
You shot me in the head!
I want blood.
All right, we're taking him in. Sir, could you please come with us?
Hey, I'm gonna curb check you into next week. Boys, get him!
Gonna be close. We're coming in too hot.
It's like a force field. Benny, get him.
Where'd you get the pants, Catman?
Aeropostale.com.
We've got to help him.
Leave him, Lenny. He's as good as dead.
I'm gonna go.
Lenny!
Don't hurt him.
There's nothing I can do! Wow. We basically just bagged this guy.
Yeah. Where'd you get that taser, Lenny?
Oh, you know, me not carrying a taser is like a woman voting.
So do you not usually carry a taser, or are you just sexist?
Does it really matter?
I guess not. What are we going to do with his body?
Oh, I know what to do with his body.
What if he wasn't even a crook? What if he just likes ski masks?
We'll leave that to the trash compactor. Chedda Cats move.
All right, boys. Now that we've bagged our first crook, we can make career choices. Then we can settle down and listen to some Limp Bizkit.
All right, what's our next move?
I say we plan our next move.
I got it. Let's fight crime at the school.
I don't know. Everybody will find out our secret identities.
No. We'll have the cat hats so no one will recognize us.
Perfect.
My foster mom says no one will recognize me anyways.
And you'll fit right in. Alright, boys. Let's split up. Lenny, you check the wastebaskets for littering. I'll see if I can get a teacher to hit me. Benny, you check the halls for inappropriate burning of CFCs.
And four, good buddy!
Move out.
Hey! Hey! Is that axe I smell? Every time you spray that on your body, a child dies in Africa. Do you not realize this? Job well done.
Al?
Here.
Hatcher.
Here.
Digit.
Here.
Chedda Jones. Chedda Jones. Chedda Jones.
Oh. You must be thinking of someone else. I'm not Chedley Jones. I'm Bengal Tiger, leader of the Chedda Cats. Perhaps you've heard of him.
I'm afraid not.
Well, you must be illiterate. We have movies out, silent movies. So you, being illiterate, would never have heard of us.
I'm going to have to ask you to remove that hat and mask. They are a distraction.
I'm afraid I can't do that. See? It's sealed on. I'm half cat, half Charles Barkley.
Half Charles Barkley?
Yes, you see, back in the 90s, a group of scientists obtained the sweat of Charles Barkley and a tiger that mauled him on the same day. Luckily, Charles survived and slam dunked its head. They combined their DNA and voila, Chedda Cat City. You can tell I'm half cat because every house I live in smells terrible.
Where does the cheddar come in?
Ask the scientists. I don't know. I'm just a clone. I can't think coherent thoughts. See, we're all clones. There were a lot of failed experiments. There was this one guy with a cat coming out of his face. We called him Pussyface for obvious reasons.
You are Chedley Jones, admit it.
Chedley Jones is dead. He couldn't appreciate the amazing support provided by a leopard leotard. Also, Chedley Jones couldn't sneak knives into school like this.
I still don't know why they expelled us. I mean, I threatened him with a knife. I didn't light him on fire.
My being expelled is an outrage. Can I make a vulgar hand gesture towards the school?
You go right on ahead.
Talk to the hand.
Don't you think that was a little bit uncalled for?
No.
Well, I guess this ices my career as an electrical engineer.
Well, make a career out of the cats. Besides, you risk a lot, moving out to Hollywood to become an engineer. You guys in? Chedda Cats 2012?
I can't. I'm afraid of commitment.
So was your father.
Shazam! But how do we make a career out of the cats?
We'll set up a home base and a hotline.
Sounds hot. The hotline, I mean.
Maybe we'll get a house with some guys. You guys in?
Well, I got nothing better to do.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear. Chedda Cats, move.
Yeah!
Nice cat suit, dork.
Yellow brick road. We ended up in black boat. Black girls taught the gift of love. Smiling children painted joy. Sunshine bright, girl and boy. Bag of tricks and candy sticks. Peppermint cat, oh my god.
Yellow brick, black boat, black.
Chedda Cat's hotline. Lick me.
I walked along happy.
Help!
You guys are better than the police.
Don't trust the police!
Buckle up and shut up.
So I'm watching TV, right, and I see this naked baby.
Let's keep it clean. These are some hot pics. Let's post them on the web.
Perfect 10. Right on. Watching this for hours, and it is time that the madness stopped.
What are you doing? Turn it back on.
Relax, it'll be on next Saturday.
Yeah, next Saturday. Change it back.
Why don't you just chill out? There's nothing wrong with reruns.
You know as well as I do, watching a rerun is like eating a dried up turkey sandwich while your mother bathes you.
Bite me.
I'll do more than bite you. I'll cut your ear off.
You wouldn't dare.
Wouldst I? Wouldst I?
Can't we all just get along?
Not with you around.
Don't you have some grocery duty to attend to?
Yeah, I got grocery duty. You just lucked out, Benny, because I'm a scrapper. I fight dirty. I want you to stay here while we're gone and think about what it means to be a team.
Sure thing, sir.
Kitty.
Oh, crap. Jumping up and down to the neighbors.
Chedley. When you started the Chedda Cats, what gave you the idea for it?
I don't know. It's just something about my head being in a tiger's mouth that rubbed me the right way. Cheddar, cheddar cheese, cheddar milk, cheddar Tylenol. I love cheddar.
Hey, Skankburger.
No name calling.
No, Skankburger. The only meat that's so good you hate yourself for it.
Skankburger. The meat lover's guilty pleasure. I'll take it.
Western family. I wanted the dinosaur fruit snacks.
Well, you better deal with it, because we're a family now.
Chedley, how do you know if a girl really likes you?
Lenny, I'm sure nobody likes you. Don't worry about it.
Oh, by the way, some old lady called her hotline. She says her son's stuck in a tree.
How long ago?
30 minutes to an hour ago.
No! He could be dead by now. Chedda Cats move.
You're here.
Calm down before I smack you across the face. Tell me where your son is.
Up there in the tree.
Stop screaming. Sweet Father Christmas. What, did you throw him up there?
No, I...
Well, you might as well have.
Get me out of here. I'm tripping. I'm tripping up a storm.
Calm down. Refrain from any swearing or jive talk.
So we, gonna, you know...
Right. That reminds me. We've been meaning to ask you this. We're all about corporal punishment, allowing blood and pain to open the door to rehabilitation.
So when your son comes down from the tree, can we hit him with a rubber hose?
What?
I guess what we're asking is, when your son gets down, can we give him the five across the eyes?
No! No, you cannot do that! Just get him down from there!
Have it your way. All right, Lenny, take him down.
You got it, Chief.
Man, oh man. That kid sure was a whiner.
Yeah, we dropped a tree on him. We didn't light him on fire.
Tell me about it. Okay, who's ready for some immoral meat?
I sure am.
You'll get more when you finish.
You're right, this skank burger is delicious.
I know. Kind of makes you feel dirty, like hot chocolate.
How so?
My cocoa isn't fair traded. Hey, Benny, check this out. Extend the pork. Ah, going in for the kill.
Hey, that's mine.
That's just too bad. And delicious.
You like little boys.
No, you like little boys.
Gets me every time.
What use would an extendable fork be, old friend?
The element of surprise. See, let's say a crook pulls a knife on you, and you pull out a fork. He'll laugh because a knife is no match for a fork, but not if it extends. I give you the extend-a-fork.
Wait till the fans hear about this.
May I be excused?
I guess I'll go talk to him.
I'll stay with the skank burger. The warning label said it might leave you during the night.
Hey, Benny. You don't have to come in here and help me. I'm just crying in the bathroom. I live like an animal.
Ah, Chief. You been hallucinating again?
No. Those days are behind me. It's just, do you ever wonder if we'll ever make it to the big time?
I thought we already were in the big time. I mean, can't we just have fun?
I can't.
Don't be so pissed off.
I can't because I don't like myself.
We still have fun. I mean, like when we ran those underage drivers off the road. Or we beat up those kids trying to sneak into an R-rated movie.
Yeah. They didn't have an adult guardian to bring them in the movie, and they didn't have an adult guardian to stop us from beating them into a pulp.
See? Things work out.
Tell that to Milli Vanilli.
What shall we do today?
I don't know. Check out those hotties.
Awesome. Let's make cat calls. Get it? Cat calls?
Why do we even keep you around?
Check out that harlot.
Oh, it's just Cynthia Benson.
Didn't you guys used to date?
Oh, we did a lot more than date. We double dated.
So why'd you guys break up?
You know, I'm not really sure. She was good looking and all, but when she talked, I would become angry. Ah, this reminds me of when we first started Chedda Cats. And we don't have to have a flashback, because it wasn't that long ago.
Hey!
You three, the Chedda Cats?
Do gypsies eat children?
Good. I thought I should warn you. There's a madman in town. He's calling himself the Sawduster. He's unhinging City Hall.
Where?
The City Hall.
That explains all that talk about City Hall. Chedda Cats, let's get out of here.
He wanted me to give this to you.
We'll tackle him like men. We'll listen to this tape when we get back to home base.
I think you're gonna need my help.
Who are you?
I'm Sergeant Earth. Pollution be afeared. Your nuisance is here.
Yeah, like we're gonna need your help. I'll believe the air's polluted when it starts telling dirty jokes. Chedda Cats, move.
This message is for the Chedda Cats. My name is the Sawduster. I'm going on tour from my home base in Illinois, destroying city halls across the nation. I'll be here all week if you want to confront me. I'm sure it would be a pleasure. Ooh.
I love pleasure. Let's go.
I love my Lucy, and she loves me too.
Hold it right there.
Eh. Ah, the Chedda Cats. I've been expecting you.
And what do you think you're doing?
I'm just doing a little freelance.
I'm afraid I can't let you do that. You've dusted your last saw, Sawduster.
I think you can come up with better than that.
You've wielded your last sharp metal object that I am afraid of, Sawduster.
Your efforts are futile. Juveniles dressed up as cats stand no chance against a senile man with power tools.
We'll see about that. Time of SmackDown, 10:15. Benny, you go in slowly on the left.
No! I'm taking him now!
Benny! No! He had beautiful eyes! passed out from lack of sight. Double team him. Never again. Get ready for lockjaw.
Holy Jebediah.
Stop this madness.
No.
Chedley! Don't hurt him.
No. He had a beautiful stomach.
Chedda Cats? More like Parmesan pussies.
You killed him. He's dead.
You think that's bad? I have 1,500 cats.
I'm gonna tap dance on your grave.
Chedda Cats, do you taste like cheddar?
That's creepy.
Is that all you got?
That's nothing compared to this.
Power level 5. Too bad.
Got owned.
What I miss? Whoa, Lenny got massacred. Hold it right there.
It's flying rodent, and its sidekick, small bird.
Indeed. Are you aware of the illegality of your actions?
No, my legs feel fine. And if killing a man I don't know in the heat of passion is a crime, then haul me away.
Any persons fighting crime will need a license issued by the Crime Fighters Association of America.
You need a license to fight crime? That's ridiculous. If that's true, you might as well need a license to drive.
And you might as well arrest McGruff the Crime Dog, and he's the best there ever was.
McGruff the Crime Dog is a paid spokesman for the association, enjoys $250,000 salary, and he loves his wife.
What a sellout.
It's all about selling out these days, kid. Because if you don't sell out, you'll be bought out.
He can't buy someone out without their permission.
You can if they're asleep.
His arguments are infallible.
So how do you get a license? How do you become a member?
That's for me to know, and you not to know, ever. But I will say this. In order to become a member of the Crime Fighters Association of America, you must already be a member.
That makes no sense.
Hate to break this to you, kid, but life doesn't make sense. You ever hear of the Big Bang Theory? Man, that stuff is whack. I just curb-checked your cat hat. And let that be a warning to you. I can't risk there being a shortage. There has to be enough crime to go around for everyone. I'm afraid I have to shut down your operation.
It's not fair. It's just not fair!
And I hate to break this to you, kid. Life's not fair. You ever played Oregon Trail? At least half the kids die on the journey. That doesn't seem fair, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Well, our work here is done. And don't try to follow us. Small bird here. He'll bust you up.
Jumping Chipotle sauce. What a couple of losers.
They sure are, small bird. They sure are. Oh yeah. Clean up your dead friend over there.
You'll take that back when we use voodoo magic to sick his corpse on you.
Yeah, whatever. To the status mobile.
Holy crap, Blaine's alive! Should we take that saw out? He's gonna die of blood loss.
Nah, blood loss is an old wives' tale. Plus, a little saw to the stomach never hurt anybody, except the ones that died from it. Let's get him out of here.
Wow. You really took one for the team this time, Lenny.
Yeah, I should be able to walk again in a couple of weeks.
Well, when you do, don't bother coming to find us.
What do you mean?
Dude, the Chedda Cats just got shut down. Or were you too busy wincing in pain to notice?
We can still be friends, right?
I'm afraid not. See, even if we were in commission, we'd cut you from the team.
Why?
Think about it. It's our first superhero fight and you throw in the towel? Not to mention massive amounts of blood.
But I tasered a crook.
That was a fluke.
And I provide unequaled moral support.
That's also a fluke. Well, Lenny, I guess this is goodbye. For eternity. Good luck dealing with my rejection.
Don't worry, I'm already suppressing the memory. I just wanted to be depended upon. Sorry, dead parents. I let you down.
It's over. Everything I ever loved, they took it from me.
We don't need some corporate scumbag to tell us what to do. We can fight crime if we want to.
You don't mess with Flying Rodent, Benny. He has lawyers. Lawyers with guns.
We can fight crime if we want to.
We can't. They'll throw us in jail. Or worse. Sue us for untold millions of dollars in lost revenue.
Then we'll just declare bankruptcy.
You are such a pessimist.
Think of the fans, man. Think of the fan mail.
I wrote the fan mail.
We have fans. Our landlord lets us live here for free.
My mom pays the rent with my dad's alimony check. The landlord spits in my face when I see him. He also spits in the cat food. It's over. Back to school under my new name, Von Brogan. You want to come pose as my butler?
Count me in.
You know, Chedley, I've been thinking.
Yeah.
If humans have a tailbone, does that mean, with the right kind of genetic engineering and hormones, that we could grow a tail? Not just any old tail, a dinosaur tail that we could whip people with.
That would rock.
It wouldn't just rock, it would dino rock. That begs the question, would we still be fighting crime if we had that kind of power?
No. If I had that kind of power, I myself would turn to a life of crime, but we don't fight crime anymore, remember?
Yeah. Book points. Balls to the wall. Well, hey, man. How's your first day back in school?
I felt naked without the suit.
Well, whose fault's that? There's no reason not to wear the suit.
Yes, there is. Because every time I wear that suit, I get the urge to hit people in ski masks and tattoos. That'll get us thrown in jail, remember? It's just like it was before.
Like what?
When I was a little kid, I wanted to play in the XFL, Extreme Football League.
That only lasted like a year.
Best year of my life.
I too wanted to play in the XFL, but you know what I did when that show was canceled?
Don't say that, they'll bring it back.
I made my own Extreme Football League. My angles were way more extreme than the league could ever film. When you first said Chedda Cats to me, Chedda, I couldn't have cared less. I don't know what it is. The excitement, the thrills, tight pants. They've really done something for me. I don't want to let it go. And I don't think you do either.
I can't. I'll go to jail.
I'm disappointing in you, Chedley. Even crooks are willing to not work for a living.
Chedda Cats is dead. I'm going to be a scholar.
Well, you can go on job hunts in your business suit. I'm going to go on witch hunts in my cat suit. Admit it. You're Bengal Tiger, leader of the Chedda Cats!
Do you realize what you just did? You just revealed my identity to the whole library.
There's nobody in the library!
The enemy has spies, Benny. Come to my house at 3 p.m. They're gonna come after me. I need protection.
I thought you said the Chedda Cats don't matter.
I gotta have something to worry about.
Chedley, don't let pride destroy your life. This is the worst book ever! So what is it you want me to do again?
You see, my enemies there, they're gonna come after me, so you're gonna stake out on the porch. And when they see you, they'll think I'm in league with a powerful Native American tribe, and they'll leave me alone.
Sounds perfectly reasonable. Going with?
Sorry, I'm too frightened to leave the couch.
Bandits! Oh man, Kirkle strike. Chedley, about your cat.
No! What did you do?
I'm sorry. I thought she was a shapeshifter.
Do you love nothing?
Hey, aren't you flying rodent, small bird?
Indeed. Come over here.
Don't worry about it. I'm such an uncompromising friend, I always look on the bright side. You just gave her some cat handlebars. Brilliant. She's just easier to pick up now. Holy stem cell research. It's flying rodent and small bird.
What?
What are they doing?
So, do I get an autograph?
Maybe. Just come over here.
Okay.
Do
Does this smell like glue to you?
I don't believe it. It's a frame job. Benny, suit up.
I thought you said the Chedda Cats was dead.
I said suit up. Justice is flying first class today, and I'm flying as co-pilot.
Who's flying as main pilot?
My best friend in the whole world is flying as main pilot.
And who would that be?
The false cat idol I worship.
We'll never make it. Get to the bikes!
As I'm rolling down Rodeo with a shotgun, I know these people ain't seen a brown-skinned man since their grandparents bought one. As I'm rolling down Rodeo with a shotgun, I know these people ain't seen a brown-skinned man since their grandparents bought one.
Good job, small bird. But make it look more like authentic gang activity.
Hold it right there.
Well, if it isn't Jonesy and the Pussycats.
And what do you think you're doing with the man in the trunk?
We're on official crime-fighting business. Will you leave us be?
You're framing that man for vandalism. So that's how you got so good at fighting crime.
No, we're really good at fighting crime. We just do this as a hobby. Like when celebrities shoplift.
I'm afraid we can't let you do that. We have songs for people like you. Stop. In the name of the law, before you break the law.
Do what you will. You're only two men.
Make that three.
Lenny, how'd you get out of the hospital?
I convinced them I didn't have health insurance.
All right. There's three of us and two of you. That makes one and a half of us for every one of you. You sure you can handle it? Chedda Cats, move. Oh!
It's over, Roden. I have the high ground.
Take that, huh?
That's a three-story fall.
Push me to desperate measures, Roden.
Fork?
Not just any fork.
Impossible.
Not impossible. Illogical.
I don't know. If I help Lenny now, he'll never learn self-reliance.
Ah!
Extendiform. You monster. It never even lived to see a full extension.
You are the lawbreaker, young man. Those are a Class D misdemeanor to possess.
Nice utility belt.
Indeed.
That's it.
Oh my god.
Oh, look who's laughing now.
Where's your sonar vision now? Hey, you got big arms. All right, dirtbag. What do you say to a 3-on-1?
I should report you for accosting a celebrity, but you're not worth it. None of you are.
Our last chance for an appeal.
I mean, work so hard to uphold the law gives us the shaft.
Yep.
I just want to kick over this candy machine. I can't believe those guys beat us in our own death match.
Yep, not cutting it. One brick short of a brick house.
One rat short of a swarm of rats.
What are we going to tell people if they ask us what happened in the fight?
We'll tell them. Yo, flying rodent.
Oh, no! Chedda Cats! Oh, no!
Handguns just went nuclear. You're the first test subject. I will cling to that lie till the day I die.
Me too.
Me either. Chedda Cats, mount.
Chedda Cats are going all the way. Yeah, Chedda Cats are gonna save the day. Chedda Cats gonna eat some Hot Pockets at the mom's house. When the dawn, Chedda Cats gonna save the day. Yeah, Chedda Cats are going all the way. Chedda Cats, fire name brand cereal kids in the Chedda Cats training bra. Chedda Cats, sanitize your needles when you're sewing your costume. Chedda Cats going all the way. Yeah, Chedda Cats are gonna save the day. The Chedda Cats say, kids, to make sure you wear protection when you're fighting crime.
Chedda, 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 Chedda. Chedda Cats.